A special event to mark the 100th anniversary of the Tulsa, Oklahoma race massacre was canceled yesterday at the very last minute. We've got new information now explaining why. Hundreds of black people were killed or injured by a white mob in that two-day rampage that began on May 31st, 1921. More than 30 blocks of black-owned homes and businesses were destroyed, and the catastrophe was covered up for decades. Omar Villafranca is tracking the decision to cancel Monday's event. Omar, this was shaping up to be a very big occasion with very big names. What happened?
Good morning. This news came as a surprise to everyone. The event was actually called Remember and Rise and had been in the works for months. And it was going to be held at Tulsa's One Oak Field on Monday, which is the 100th anniversary of the massacre. Singer John Legend, activist Stacey Abrams were set to headline the nationally televised event. Tickets were sold. 6,000 people were going to attend. But CBS News has learned that an attorney for the survivors and their heirs made demands that the organizing commission considered unreasonable. Now, in their public statement, the organizers cited unexpected circumstances with entertainers and speakers. But a commission source showed us an email of demands that were sent on Sunday from a lawyer representing survivors and their descendants. It includes $1 million each for survivors of the massacre and a non-negotiable $50 million pledge to a fund for survivors and descendants. Now, the source also tells us that the commission and the attorney had already agreed on financial terms, but the new demands could not be met, at least in time for Monday's events. And Gail, we spoke to the lawyer about his email. I want to get this correct. He claimed that the commission had not been negotiating in good faith for months and that the survivors had never agreed to be at that big event. Now, the commission is also saying there are other events that are planned. They will go on as planned, and they're hoping they can still mark the day what happened and also highlight the efforts to pay restitution.
Well, we certainly have to mark the day, but there sure seems to be more to that story, Omar. More to come, I'm sure, about that. Thank you, Omar Villafranca, very much.